What's up, guys? This is Matt, and you're watching Movie Punch for Tuesday, August 11th. And today we're just going to talk about some movie news. So there was several things that happened in the world of movies today. I'm going to talk about the three things that really caught my eye. The first one of those being the first official look at the Black Panther costume from the upcoming Captain America Civil War. Now, this isn't an official photo or publicity shot or anything like that. It's just a couple of behind the scenes photos. They were posted on Instagram by user Meyer Photos, and they feature one shot of Black Panther and the Winter Soldier, Bucky Barnes. Looks like maybe they're climbing up the side of a building or maybe onto a roof. I don't think that was Sebastian Stan as Winter Soldier. I think that was maybe the stuntman. But this shot does give you a good idea of what the Black Panther suit will look like. The other shot is just a Black Panther from behind. It looks like maybe he's scaling down the side of a building. There's some wire work going on there. The suit looks pretty great. It looks a little bit weird. Some people online were saying that it doesn't look good or that it looks like paper mache or things like that. But you have to remember that these things, especially superhero suits and the bright colors that are contained in them, usually lighting is a big factor in making these look good, and it looks like these were taken in broad daylight, middle of the day, or if they weren't, there was a lot of lighting going on. I think it's gonna turn out looking great. It also may have been a padded stunt suit. Usually those don't look so great as well. I remember the first image of the Captain America suit from Captain America the First Avenger. The first behind the scenes shot of that was of the stunt actor in the stunt suit, and it looked real big and puffy and everybody was complaining about it, but the actual movie suit combined with lighting made it look pretty good. So I'm gonna hold judgment out on this. I still think it looks pretty good, but we don't get any really good face shots or close-ups. They're both from kind of behind Black Panther and from sort of far away. So I think it's gonna look great. Of course, we'll have to wait for the first publicity shot to really know for sure, but I think it's gonna end up looking really, really good. The suit looks a lot like the concept art that we saw a few months back, and I thought that looked great. So I really think this is on the right track. I can't wait to see it, and I have every confidence that this suit is going to look incredible. The next thing I want to mention is the fact that we got 12 new photos from Star Wars The Force Awakens. So these were released on Entertainment Weekly's website, EW.com, and they give us a little bit of insight, a little bit more insight into the story, but still nowhere near enough to really know what's going on. We just kind of get a little bit more idea of maybe who a couple of these characters are and what their role is in the film, but we definitely don't know anything still about the story or the main plot points. Among these photos, we got shots of Kylo Ren, played by Adam Driver, General Hux, played by Domhnall Gleeson, Captain Phasma, played by Game of Thrones' Gwendolyn Christie. We got a couple more shots of Finn and Rey, played by John Boyega and Daisy Ridley, respectively. And we got a nice shot of Poe Dameron, played by Oscar Isaac. We also get shots of Finn leaving the scene of a crashed TIE fighter and Rey cutting BB-8 out of a scavenger's net. So again, those are like little tiny story points that we get, but it doesn't really reveal anything about the plot at all. So to see all of these awesome photos, be sure to go to EW.com. We will put the link in the description below so you can see all of those. And the last bit in movie news that we'll cover today is the first official trailer for The Hateful Eight. So this is Quentin Tarantino's next movie, and it's essentially a movie set a few years after the Civil War. And it basically features a group of bounty hunters as they're taking refuge from a blizzard, and they run into an unexpected group of folks, and hilarity ensues. So I don't know a whole lot about the story yet, but it's Quentin Tarantino, so I'm definitely going to want to see it. It looks like it's going to be kind of typical, well, sometimes typical Tarantino, with sort of a small cast in a confined setting. Kind of reminds me a little bit of Reservoir Dogs or some parts of Pulp Fiction, and you can bet that there's going to be some colorful language as well. Maybe Quentin Tarantino will make an appearance. He loves to hear himself talk in his own movies. That's not necessarily a bad thing. It's just sort of a trait of his, but it looks really, really good, really interesting. A really, really interesting cast. Sam Jackson, Kurt Russell, Tim Roth. It's an all-star cast. Jennifer Jason Leigh. So with that kind of cast together under Quentin Tarantino, I think we're in for probably another blockbuster, but we'll have to wait and see. So that's everything I wanted to cover for today. There was some other movie news, but those were the top three things that really caught my eye. So if you want to see some other videos, I hope to do some more like this. please subscribe by clicking the button below. And you can also go to youtube.com/nerdpunch to get all of our other videos. You can also follow us on Twitter, Twitch, and Facebook, all of those /nerdpunch. And of course, we've got nerdpunch.com for all of the other cool stuff that we are looking at online. And it's another great place to go to check our schedule for some of our upcoming videos. And until next time, I'll talk to you guys later. See ya.